So in this video, I will be discussing about organization of insect body. So insect body is differentiated into three distinct regions like head, thorax and abdomen. So grouping of the body segments into distinct regions is known as tagmosis. So in simple words, the differentiation of body into distinct functional regions is called as tagmosis. The body regions are called as tagmata, that is, head is the first tagma, thorax is the second tagma, and abdomen is the third tagma. So let us look at the first tagma, head, from the frontal view. Head consists of two pair of, a pair of compoundes, a pair of antenna, three simple eyes called oculi, and mouth parts. It also consists of various head areas, sutures, and sulcus. Topmost portion of the head present between the compound eyes or behind the compound eyes is the vertex, whereas area present below the frontal suture, so these two are the frontal suture, and above the frontoclypeal sulcus is frons. Frontoclypeal sulcus is also called as epistomal sulcus. Sclerotized plate present below the epistomal sulcus is clypeus, whereas lateral portion of the head beneath the compound eyes is genu. So if you look at this, it is the inverted Y-shaped suture at which old cuticle splits during the molding is egg-digel cleavage line. It is also called as epicranial suture. Line surrounding the base of the compound eyes is called as circumocular, and this one. And if line surrounding the antenna, base of the antenna is called as circumantennal sulcus. Circumantennal sulcus and circumocular sulcus. So for better easy understanding purpose, if we compare the insect head with the human face, let us assume it as epistomal sulcus, and below the epistomal sulcus area is the clypeus, and this one is the upper lip, labrum. And let us assume it as frons just above the epistomal sulcus, and these two are compound eyes, whereas the topmost portion of the head is the vertex. So if you look at the head from the lateral view, so area present above the mandibular articulation or behind the mandibular articulation is called as subgenu. If the subgenal part present above the mandibular articulation is called as pleurostoma. If it is behind the mandibular articulation, it is called as hyperstoma. And if the area posterior to the occipital sulcus, it is called as postgenu. So this is the occipital sulcus. And this one is the occipital this suture, it's the suture or sulcus behind the compound eyes and in front of the occiput. Whereas this is the post occipital suture. According to Snodgrass, it is the only the true suture present in insect head is post occipital suture. It lies behind the occiput. And there are six segments present in insects. Head, one is the antennal segment, ocular segment, intercalary, mandibular, maxillary and labial segments. And in insect head, if you look at the posterior part, these are the sutures and sulcus present in insect head. So head joins the thorax with the help of cervix. So cervix, through cervix, head joins the thorax. The function, main function of the head is ingestion of food particles. Apart from that, sensory perception, coordination of body activities, protection of the coordinating center. So let us look at the second insect tagma, that is thorax. So thorax is the second tagma, which consists of locomotory organs. So thorax is differentiated into prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. So these Three pairs of legs are present in thorax, each pairs on each thoracic segment, whereas two pairs of wings are present on meso and metathoracic segments. That's why meso and metathoracic segments are collectively called as pterothorax. Spiracles are also present on meso and metathoracic segments laterally. So in general, the thoracic notum, dorsal part of the thorax is called as notum or tergum, whereas lateral portion is pleura and ventral portion is sternum. So if you look at the thoracic notum, this one, it is divided into anterior ulnotum and posterior postnotum. Anterior ulnotum gives rise to wing, whereas this ulnotum gives rise to internally inflected fragma. The pseudoscutellar suture, this one divides the scutum and scutellum. So this ulnotum, which consists of two pair of wing processes, that is anterior wing processes and posterior wing processes. If you look at here, a pair of anterior notal wing processes and posterior notal wing processes, which helps in attachment of wings at the notal region, that is dorsal side of the thorax. So let's look at the pleural region. So it is again divided into anterior episternum and posterior epimeron. So just below the notal wing processes here, so you can see two sclerites, basilar and subbalar sclerites. These two sclerites helps in attachment of wings at the pleural region, and this one is the coxal cavity. So the ventral side of the thorax, that is the ventral side, if we look at here, so again it is differentiated into anterior eusternum and posterior spinosternum. So eusternum again differentiated into presternum, basisternum and sternella. The main function of the thorax is concerned with the locomotion, because it consists of locomotory organs. So if you look at the abdomen, that is the third insect tagma. So abdomen consists of, typical insect abdomen consists of 11 segments and 8 pair of spiracles, which are located on first to 8th abdominal segments. So each abdominal segments are joined by the interconnected membrane called as conjunctiva. So if you look at the female abdominal, posterior part of the female abdominal segment, so it consists of ovipositor. So this ovipositor consists of two pairs of valvifers, like this one is the valvifer 1 and this one is the valvifer 2, and it also consists of three pairs of valvuli, like valvuli 1, 2, 3. So this one is the inner valvuli, median valvuli and dorsal valvuli. So dorsal and the inner one, which acts, which useful to dig the soil. So these two, dorsal and ventral, dorsal as well as ventral valvuli, which helps in digging the soil during oviposition, whereas the median one, valvuli 2, which acts as egg guide during the deposition of the egg. So this, the posterior part also consists of three lobes, like one was the epiproct and a pair of paraproct. These two forms the anus. So apart from, a pair of sensory structures are present called as cerci. So female genitalia is present on 8th and 9th abdominal segment. So if you look at the male abdomen, the posterior part of the male abdomen, so usually male genitalia present on 9th abdominal segment. So this is a clasper, which helps in clasping the female during mating. It is mainly concerned with the reproduction and metabolism.